嗨，嗨，Wow, this is a mess. Hi, Wolfgang. Hi. How is everybody in TV land? Hello. Hi. Oh, I could have gone out to dinner tonight, but I didn't go out to dinner tonight because I got some chicken. And I am gonna get some. Jethro was buying me some fried rice and an egg roll. Vegetable fried rice, since I don't eat too much vegetables. But while we're waiting for that, I'm thinking of doing some laundry. Way. All right, there's Wolfgang is over there. And here we are. Well, New York, the weather in New York is like really shit. Yay, laundry. Oh, hi, Wolfgang. You want to come here and say hello? Would you like to come? the weather, I got caught, man. Oh, God, what a day I had. Oh, I gotta say. I had some day. Tomorrow I will be at home. I have decided. I saw my mama today for Mommy's Day. Tomorrow I'm gonna be home. And I will be cooking a lasagna and a meatball and a sausage. It's gonna be an Italian day. So tomorrow is gonna be cooking. Yes. So we're gonna do that. Right, Wolfgang? We're gonna cook. So tonight we're waiting for the Chinese man to come. And so that's what we're doing tonight. Oh, did you change the letters of your name? Because, or am I seeing things? Oh, I'm not sure. One letter is aqua color. I have. Well, who the hell is the angel with the blue one? First one was in black. On my screen, it's blue. Hi, baby. Say hi. Oh, you want to say hello? Oh, there he is. There he is. Handsome man. He came shopping with me and my mama today. He's a good boy. My mama even said, "My mama don't lie." Ain't he cute? Kiss. You're grumpy. Okay, we are gonna do a few things. First off, the weather. Oh, cute grunt. Weather in New York sucks. Oh my I don't know if you could see, it's all raining out. Hello? Yes. All right, let me move the camera away from the door. All right. I'm not. But I just started my show and I'm gonna do my laundry. You're not. God. Yeah, and I gotta give you that other stuff. All right, so when you come around. All right, well, why don't you go? Okay, goodbye. I can't see the rain. All right. Oh, God. I'm trying to do. This is all it is a documentary of my life. A documentary of my life, and that's it. This is all it is. Can't see the rain. Yeah, well. Trust me. I can't move the camera right now. So the camera is not getting moved. All right. All right. I gotta put music on for a minute. Okay. It's a live documentary. All right. Let's see if I could find this so you guys could listen. All right, I'm gonna put this on. This inspired me when I was about 12 years old. So, all right, here you go. It's 9 minutes long, and I have a few things to do.
You didn't say that.
Yeah, but what?
Social status, equal to the whites.
Opportunity for
Glad you care.
Really bad soundtrack. Very bad. Is there a better version I could put on?
But you.
Alright, let's see that.
Let me introduce the rest of the lads from that side. Lance, you know, and next is Michelle, who is 15.
That was the first
Kevin,
documentary in the whole wide world.
Now. Am I going too fast? Grant, 19. Can you find Grant, though? Grant's way over there. And Delilah, 17. Don't leave anyone out besides myself, 36. How do you feel about the way you came off and the way you look in the series? Anyone want to grab that?
I felt when I watched myself on the series, I kind of mumbled a lot, and I walked on the ramp. I'd walk on and laugh and walk off and come back on and mumble something. I was very disappointed, very disappointed.
Yeah.
But you always, you're kind of critical of yourself when you see yourself on TV.
Well, how did you feel when you said something?
I felt that I was very aware of it. I was pressed for something to say when there was no action or anything. You'd just be sitting there talking to friends or something. And viewing yourself, you think, oh God, say something intelligent. Just don't sit there. You know, because if you're just sitting there and they're filming you, there's nothing you can say except try and strike up, hey, I know it's school today. Great.
Pay
just
attention to
just
this
because
tape.
You need to say something.
Yes, you
always
for
something.
Yeah. What do you think?
I don't know. I just.
When did he say that?
And is it happening now?
Yeah.
Is it happening now?
No.
Yeah. You have a rock and roll band. Do you still have it?
Oh, yeah. We've got a new one going now. It's, I think that needs a little explanation because the one that you see in the film isn't my band. It was just a band that asked me to sing with them.
We were just we had a bunch of friends up at the house, and it was Friday evening. We're out of school, and we're just kind of partying around. And you get an urge to play guitar, so we went in.
Shit,
and,
about
and,
a laundry
a bit,
soap.
And we got a write-up in the San Francisco paper that said there. Grant and Kevin Lott are absolutely terrible rock and roll musicians.
All right, well, we'll watch with the fabric.
But anyway,
we
Grant
don't
and I played together in a group called Bulldog, and we joined, before we were playing different bands, and we joined together and got a drummer named Jim Sides, who's very good. He has a cute girlfriend, too.
Hey, wait a minute. In the series, you're going into your father's business, and now you seem like you're going into music.
No, Grant and I started playing guitar, I guess we were about 7th or 8th grade. Dad said you wanted to go to Australia on a sailor's trip, and I was going to say, I got an important rock and roll band going, so I said,
I see.
Something on that, another thing in the series is that they've sort of categorized us. You know, I have a little bit more to me than just a dancer, you know. Mm-hmm. I do a little bit more than just go to school. And they, Kevin does a little bit more than want to follow into his father's footsteps, et cetera, et cetera. Mm-hmm. But I thought that a lot of the reviews and stuff just put us into our own little box around there or something else to us.
Well, as Lynn said, you take two aspirin, the next day it's over. Yeah.
But the thing is, I think basically the idea that you're categorized in front of so many people gives you that much more power to prove them wrong, because everybody's once they see someone doing one thing, you know, they're more or less nowadays, as we go into the future, more or less pleased as a change takes place in front of public eye. I think this gives us a good chance to build off of that. You know, when I saw myself build as Homo of the Year 1971, I was really despondent for a while.
It's sort of funny to play against the type that's been created for you.
Yeah. No one likes to put the boxes, you know. Say, this is a future businessman, this is a dancer, this is a underworld set.
Yeah.
We don't say homo because that newspaper says don't say.
Are you two, do you get along with your brother who lives in New York City and has seen it so different from you?
Okay. Two peas in a pod.
Kevin gets along with me a lot, but...
Wait, there are three peas here.
Kevin gets along with me, but he doesn't get along with my world.
Well, that's all right.
It's okay. I mean, as long as he can accept me, it's fine.
Yeah.
He has a tendency when he visits us to walk off with any clothes that we might happen to do. Time before he visited us, he talked me into buying this jacket, which cost $20. He came back the next time and took the jacket, which cost $20.
I'm just getting it broken in for a while.
Did you know he was a criminal? Is that something you've learned from the series?
When I was 7 years old, he talked me into lending him $5 for a stuffed animal. Never got my $5 back.
Here's the time you collect it.
Kevin's a born accountant. But he's also a slugger.
Okay. Before we take the message we're about to take, just a show of hands, anyone who wouldn't do it all over again? Anyone here? You'd all do it again.
In a minute.
Okay, we got a message. We'll be right back.
Alrighty. Yes, the loud family interview. Those were the people that inspired me so much to do a documentary. We don't have any laundry soap, so we're just using fabric. We're just using fabric cleaner. I don't think that's good, because my clothes aren't really that dirty, so. All right. Well, Jethro treated me to Chinese food tonight, and so that is why. Well, that's not the only reason why. I actually could have gone out tonight, but I'm very tired, and I don't feel good. So, alright, let's see what else. What else I can do? That's nice of Meg. So I know that the loud family interview wasn't that good. Lance Loud, I had the biggest crush on him. He was in the show.
And came to New York and joined what's called the Underground. It was reported that when he was a teenager, he dyed his hair silver in imitation of his hero, Andy Warhol. In recent interviews, he's been amazingly frank about all kinds of things, and he's certainly not shy. He's sitting right here, Lance Loud. Hello, Lance.
Hi.
You've emerged as a kind of a star of the series in a way, and
yeah.
What kind of reactions
sort of
are you
like,
getting?
The Linda, whatever her name is, of Deep Throat, sort of. Linda Lovelace.
Linda.
But,
more of a
G-rated audience.
Are you sore about the...
No, I love it. I get a suntan thinking from it.
I don't know if you're putting me on or not.
No, I honestly mean that.
You're glad you did it, and you I'm
sure I'm glad I did it. I don't watch this series, really. I like to see about the last 10 minutes of every show. Because even though maybe it doesn't portray us as the way we had wished and dreamed it would, they really do sort of all of a sudden, no matter how draggy the entire hour seemed, they suddenly pull themselves together and really throw on that old drama at the end and freeze out and play some good music or something. I really like that.
Okay. What kind of response are you getting from people around you and... the general public?
Well, I've gotten a lot of true hearts sent to me in the mail, and a lot of blank phone calls where people call up and murmur things into the phone and hang up. But I love that. I love hearing people. I can talk to people better that I don't really know than people that I know.
Which category am I again?
You're a good sport, but we haven't had dinner together or anything.
So you have your doubts about me, is it?
No, I don't doubt. That's the thing. When I don't meet anybody, I certainly don't doubt them. I mean, I'll accept them anyway, even if they want me to sell Brillo. I'd like to do an advertisement for Levi Jeans, but
So you're hoping this will be a stepping stone to all kinds of opportunities.
Yeah, but I feel like if I step on it too hard, I'm gonna sink right through it.
Can you be completely serious in this answer? Do you think your parents' feelings about you have changed because of the show?
No, they've basically been amplified. You know, some of the charm of growing up is that you do have a certain play between your parents, a little bit of mystery here. Out the window, and they call the psychiatrist saying, listen, you've got to make Lance confide in you and stuff. You know, all that mystery of whether the truth is going on within family is all sort of nice. And now that the film has really been brought out and they've been made to talk about it, my parents' feelings really, they grab to the nearest ideal and the nearest moral that they can. And sometimes they listen against me. But we are all growing up.
Do you get along with them any better in any way than you did before you did?
Oh, no. But I love my father. My mother's a great person. I really like her a lot. But we had actually never got along better before or since this film, because there was so much left to be said in it. It wasn't that no one understood it, and we weren't pretending. It was just that, Jesus, I didn't want to get into a fight with her after I hadn't seen her in 6 months, and I was hoping that she was going to be able to elevate me from the scene.
In the episode where she came to visit you for the first time and see the scene you were living in New York, you said you were hoping that she would...
I had actually wanted her to take me and put me in a little apartment of my own. I'd become a busboy with Flash and, you know, something like that. Really retire into the masses. I would have liked to do that.
Are you serious?
I'm really serious.
Okay. Because I know you have a sense of humor, and I just never
know
it's there.
Sometimes I gag on it, but I still really am basically.
So, well, are you saying there then that I want to... I'll try to be serious.
Oh, I get it.
Are you saying there, though, that you hope for something from your mother, maybe, that you would have gotten if the thing hadn't been being filmed at the time and been on television, but that because it was on television, you behaved in a certain way and maybe she behaved in a certain way that didn't allow your life to go on the way it might have?
No, I don't think I don't think that, basically. I think that maybe she would have been left in the dark about a lot more things.
Would that be good or bad?
In a way, it would be good, but I mean, I don't want her to grow up with
with too many illusions.
I mean, they've cast a lot of a totally different set of illusions during the film, but one thing that's been made clear to her now, even though she still denies it, is that I am 21, and I'm not only Lance Loud, son of Pat and Bill Loud, but I'm more or less 21 years old and a person.
Yeah.
And I now I'm sort of, I'm allowed to feel and react the way I want to react and not the way I'm supposed to react in front of customers.
Uh-huh. I said earlier that they never used the word homosexual in the publicity of the show. I don't think it even came up during it. And yet you've given a couple of interviews in which you're quite frank about it. Hard to do in the year 1970?
No, I was actually surprised that they brought up the idea that homosexuality is something more than just liking to give kisses to boys on the sly, you know. I wanted it, I knew what I was going to come off as anyway.
Mm-hmm.
As Jerry Ragney put it when I moved in Chelsea, I was a fat ass opportunist. Unfortunately, I didn't come off as much of an opportunist as I would have liked. But,
can you explain that one more?
Well, I feel that the way they edited it, they made me seem obnoxious, and I really do get harder and harder to swallow during the entire series. I mean, not that I'm so outrageous, just that I'm so dedicatedly stupid, you know? I really think I'm Mr. Cool.
On the screen?
Yeah.
Yeah.
24 hours a day. But the thing is, they cut a little bit of a lot of the friction and the dynamicism, and all that, you know, energy that really would reveal that I was not only a fat-ass opportunist, but this was merely a stage, and I was going through it, and I would go on.
Might you have told your mother certain things that you wouldn't have told her if the
no,
was there?
No, we told
them all
in the taxi cab.
Between takes, is what you're saying? That you lived some of your life in between segments, so that things you really wanted to say.
Well, yeah. Well, you see, the idea, the thing behind that is that, basically, when the cameras hit us, we were sort of ready for response, but response in a way that, well, they're in our lives, but what we want are the angles of our backs, you know, our the backs of ourselves, of our person. Instead of turning around and smiling at the camera, we usually just sort of gave a gratifying wink once in a while to let them know that we knew they were there.
Except when you say we, you mean you or you know, all of you?
We, all, everyone.
You were aware that you were on though somewhere. I mean, you kind of played to the camera a couple of times. I think you admitted in the interview that you, when you thought things were dragging, you gave what you thought was a soulful look and you came off just looking stupid or something you said in the interview.
Yeah. I really wanted to come off a lot more brutal. Simply, as I said before, just simply to show that I was going on and someday I was going to be bruised or battered enough to be able to understand some other way.
How about the things that are written about you now? Do you feel that you've been badly treated by the press?
Well, I don't know. Maybe some people enjoy swimming next to an electric eel, but...
Well, I understand that. What does that mean?
Oh, that refers to the New York Times Sunday Night Edition. What was written about me.
Oh,
that's
yes.
The only one that really hurt me, but
yeah.
I took two aspirin and it was gone.
Is your life better now that you've moved to New York?
Jesus, no.
No.
All my clothes are creeping up on me and attacking me and rotting and my bed is falling apart. I can complain all night. It could be 90 minutes about Lance's apartment if you want to talk about it.
Okay. Stay with us. We'll be right back after this message.
Right, so that was what inspired me to do a documentary. I looked at that when I was about 12 years old. Lance Loud, I had the biggest crush on him and he was gay. Yeah. I know how to pick him. I had the biggest crush on Lance. Oh God. Every week on Channel 13, I would turn that on. I loved that show. It's a documentary. Just as my show is documentary, that's documentary. So, yeah. So, you know, it's like, you know, you either like a documentary or you don't like a documentary. It's a documentary about a person's life. I could have gone out to dinner tonight, but I wanted to stay home. And I didn't feel like going out. I'm not really a going out type of person. So I canceled yet two times for a date. That doesn't sound like a gold digger to me. I just don't really want to go out. I like to stay home. I'm just that type of person. I like to stay with him. It's all about him. That's my boyfriend. That's my man. That's who I sleep with. That's who I love. Is there something wrong with that? I don't think so. Alright, the next song goes out to Wolfgang. Which is really like ruling my life, but I love him. Yeah.
In the hands of my love. And my
right, so I'm addicted to my dog.
All right. I was talking on the phone with my brother-in-law about my visit to New York. I'm addicted to my dog. I mean, look at him. Is that like perfection? Oh my God. He is so cute. That's where they are. They're hugging themselves. They're ashamed to be in my room. I really don't care. It's a documentary. I really don't give a shit. I really don't care where they are. If they don't want to sign in, let them not sign in. Who bloody cares? Yeah, they're just busy watching. They're weirdos, I would say. Weirdos. They don't have, balls to sign in. Whatever. Be wallflowers all your life. My problem.
Hey, hell, I pay the price. All those to be left.
Person in the whole wide world. My mom. My mama is God to me. My mama is God to me. Alright. I cut my bangs today. How did I do? I cut them because they were too long and excellent. My mama said they look long to her, but I don't like them any shorter than this. Anybody in the room has bangs? Cause bangs are, I've had bangs all my life. People tell me to grow my bangs out. No. I like bangs. I'm a bang type of person. Yesterday on my show, I banned, but I unbanned a Tinkerbell. She said that I should wear my hair up, that I would look younger. I hate when people tell me how to wear my hair, so I got pissed off and I banned her. But I unbanned her, because I don't think she meant really any harm on it. So I unbanned her, but I don't think that she's gonna come back here. I think she's angry. I think she got very angry with me. She might. Well, we'll see. The Farmer's Almanac seems correct. It looks like we're going to be in for rain. Rain season is here. They said that New York City is going to be so hot that it's going to be unbelievable. We're in for a very, very brutal summer. We are in for a really bad summer, and it's going to be raining like hell, frizzy hair days and all that. Okay. So all those people that are ahead of me, way hot there. What the hell are you all thinking? Well, the audience people, there's some intelligent people and there's some ignorant people, I guess. Everybody in this room is intelligent to be here, but everybody that is not in the room, I call stupid. Stupid people. Donkeys. Everybody that's not in my room are donkeys. Donkeys. Hot weather for Arizona. 90 degrees. 14. There you go. Perfect paradise. Nice. I like that. That sounds good.
You.
do I make honey mustard sauce? How do I make the honey mustard sauce? No. A little honey. So a little mustard. Not that much mustard. Right. All right, just... How's your food? Honey mustard for my chicken. Could you be on speaker or no? Because I can't hold this. Throw one out the window. Oh, shit. Just like one is good. I mean, if you have, I'll have it. You know what? This is like really delinquent. You know, this is really delinquent. What happened? Well, no, they gave you 10. What happened to... What? Hi, Orlando Broad. Oh, whoa. Hi, OB. Are you an OB doctor? Are you going to send the rib down now or not? No, I don't want you to do it. No, I know. Right. I have the washing machine here. It's like hard to do everything. Go out there? All right, hold on here. I go. You want to stay on the phone? You want to be on speaker? I'll go. I gotta go out. So I'm gonna get me a rib. My
honey mustard came out.
Wow. Not crispy, it's cold. I can't eat like this. This is almost done. Magic, it's gonna end right now. I wanna eat in peace. Please shut up, washing machine. Oh God, now my dog is looking at him. Oh God, this is like, you know what? I need to turn the toaster up. Oh God, yay! All right, the washing machine is done. All right, now I could have more room in here. Oh, I mean, this is like... ridiculous. I know my kitchen is not as clean as Mr. Taylor's, but what can I tell you? Alright, so I could eat dinner. I'm gonna turn my toaster oven on, and I'm gonna try to get that chicken. I should have gone out to eat tonight. I don't know what possessed me to stay in the house. Well, that was because I took my mom out. And, alright, there's not that much clothes here, trust me. Hey, oh, amen. All right, and then now I'm gonna heat up the chicken in a minute. Hi, Wolf. Heat up this chicken. If I don't like it, I'm gonna be really pissed off. I should have never gotten this chicken. I don't even know if I'm gonna like this. It's not hot. I got it a couple of hours ago. Wrap it up. Tin foil. All right. Try to heat it up. I don't know if that's gonna help. Oh, fuck. Oh, God. seems like it's kind of too high up.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Got a rib here. Oh, heat it up. I got a rib.
Wow, I got two ribs. Chicken is good too. Oh, what did I just do?
What happened?
It's really bad to eat. Hi, Martha.
Oh, my Lord.
Oh.
No, wait.
I have no idea.
The egg roll is hot.
I'm very depressed. This is vegetable fried rice. I didn't think that peas came in vegetable fried rice, but I don't know what it is. Broccoli comes in here too. Oh, Wolfgang, you really have to stop hounding me like this. It's like quite uncomfortable to eat when somebody is like up your ass, you know what I'm saying? Probably eat nothing of. Do you eat your you're eating salad. Do you eat your fried rice if you ever get it with duck sauce? I can't eat it without duck sauce. I never had vegetable fried rice, actually. They got broccoli in it. Oh, my dog is having a fit. It's quite excellent. It's a good way to get your veggies in. Broccoli. Alright, Wolfgang, here. Look at that big piece. Leave me alone. Please leave me alone. You don't want it, or you want it broken? Oh, now you don't want it now. You gotta be kidding me.
honey mustard. I'm not doing that. Honey mustard does not seem to go with fried rice, egg roll, and olive oil. No, I'm not gonna. I'm gonna dip my. This dog keeps on looking at me.